Hello, welcome to A to Z Ozone. Today what we'll be doing is showing you the proper way to clean your ozone plates so that way you can extend the life of them and hopefully get more out of your unit and be more satisfied. Alright, so on the older units you have 7 screws around the outside. On the newer units you are going to have 6 screws around the outside. So at this time it's time to go ahead and remove those. So you want to take those screws and put them in a cup off to the side, and then you'll go ahead and take the outside plate or outside cover off. It'll be a little tight in there because of the little lip. It's meant to wedge in between those two spots, so it can be a little more difficult to get out. Alright, so here is your ozone plates. You have 2 of them on an A7K. You'll want to go ahead and take a razor blade, such as this one, just like a flat, straight razor blade. And then if you notice right here, there's a solder joint right here where it's soldered together. You'll want to make sure not to hit that with the razor blade, because if you do hit it with the razor blade too hard, or if you hit it at the wrong angle, it can fracture that solder, which will then cause there not to be the conductivity between the two plates, and you'll lose the ozone plate itself and you'll have to then replace them. So having that in mind, try and stay away from the solder itself. You'll want to make sure to hit these grid lines here and make sure that they are nice and shiny whenever they're done to where they look like they're new. So go ahead and take your razor blade and scrape across the plate. You want to make sure to scrape evenly so that way all the lines get the proper amount of scraping on them. Alright, so there's one plate done. Go ahead and clean off any of the oxidized materials that you have on the blade itself. And then go ahead and continue on with your next plate. You want to do it a couple times until you start to see the metallic finish come back. Alright, then go ahead and clean off the edge of your razor blade again, removing all the oxidized material. And then you can either take a paper towel or you can just blow across the plate to remove any of the oxidized material that might be just setting on top of it. And then at that point, you're good to go ahead and close up the side of the unit before testing it. Alright. Go ahead and place your screws back into the unit. So now that all of your screws are back in place, go ahead and take your power cord, plug it in the back of the unit, plug the other end to your wall outlet or extension cord, whatever you have. And then go ahead and turn it on. And then look in the side and you should be able to see the purple glow throughout the whole plate instead of any spotting that you might have seen before. Alright, if you have any questions, comments, or have any ideas for our next video, please leave them in the messages below. We'd love to hear back from you. We always need more ideas for what you want to see in a video, and we'd be more than happy to make it. We just need your guys' feedback, so please leave a comment below if you want to see any other videos. Thank you and have a great day.